Important message, do what you love, always on Afternoon Express. Thank you so much to Lira. Now, Lira has to be, undoubtedly, a force to be reckoned with within the South African music culture. The award-winning singer and songwriter joins us for a special catch-up. The seasoned soulstress gives us some insights on what she thinks about the standards for women in the industry of late. Plus, we also find out what audiences can expect from her moving forward. So if you've got any questions for Lira, leave a comment on our socials using the hashtag Afternoon Express. Lira, my darling, come through.
That's, how are you? So good to see you.
So good to have you finally on Afternoon Express.
Thank you so much.
That's the amount of poise, the amount of control you have in your voice, but still belting it, giving your all, and of course with such a beautiful message, doing what you love. I mean, how does it feel to have come so far in the music industry? I mean, South Africa definitely sees you as our darling. You are our superstar. You're our shining light. How has that transition throughout your life feel like?
Obviously in the beginning it was difficult, but I look back now and I'm just so grateful for the journey. I realize that some of the trials and tribulations, they actually build your character. You almost need them. But of course, when you're going through it, you curse every moment. But also South Africa has been so supportive. Really just, I am privileged and proud to be South African. I literally saw on the wind that I'm given by the South Africans. I'm literally flapping my wings and they're giving me that life.
Absolutely.
So to all of you watching, I thank you from the bottom of my heart.
And we thank you not only for being you and standing so firm in who you are, but of course, you know how they say music, food, smells, things remind you and you end up reminiscing on some moments in your life, whether it's Christmas and we put that Lira DVD on and now a whole family has sculpted memories based off of the work that you do. I mean, how phenomenal is that? What would you say are your career highlights?
It's actually interesting that you should mention that. When I pictured myself as an artist, I used to watch family members gather around and you know, get lost in music. As a seven-year-old child, I thought if ever there was a reason to write music, that is the effect that I would want to have.
I just got goosebumps.
Exactly. So as you bring it about, I'm like, it's like so full circle, you know? And I've seen that. I've seen people playing DVDs at Christmas time or when people are gathered together. And that's really why I do what I do. It's just to create that sense of unity among people and to just, you know, just infuse people with positivity. But some career highlights that I can think of is performing for the late great Nelson Mandela as well as Barack Obama, the first South African and the first American black president. That was quite key for
me. I'm sure you like pinched yourself and you're like, girl, you did that.
Oh my gosh. My mind was blown. My mind was seriously blown. I thought, okay, well that's a good one to have under my belt. And I think the first time I had my big concert in at Big Top Arena, that was 10 years ago. Can you imagine? That was exactly 10 years ago. It was one of the biggest risks that I took in my career.
How so?
Well, at the time, DVDs weren't selling like crazy, but I wanted to record something that was global quality. So we used 13 red cameras, and we held the record for being the only production worldwide to have used those particular cameras in any production. The only other production that topped that record was The Hobbit.
Really?
So that was exciting.
And
for
that
me.
Is like an international blockbuster.
Exactly.
But then that just speaks to the level of artist that you are and what you bring to the table consistently. I mean, whether it's in your image, whether it's through your sound and your music, you are just steadily climbing from height to height. I mean, now you're internationally recognized. And a lot of that plays to your brand, what we see. And a lot of the time we see, especially in female artists in the music industry, that they're kind of flopping, changing wherever the trend goes. They go. How do you feel about the current climate in terms of not only South Africa but international females in the industry?
Well, what I find is interesting. I see a lot more reflection of women like me. What excites me about that is that we're getting more comfortable about who we are. Of course, there's still the trend, you know, there's trends, but there's people or the world is paying attention to who we as Africans are telling the world we are. That excites me. These are very exciting times. So for anyone who's a woman who's young, be brave, be yourself. You will leave a better mark in the world if you do that. So it's the people that really introduced a new narrative that the world is paying attention. You're sitting up and paying attention. So be brave.
Absolutely.
Be brave.
I think bravery, though, is so much easier said than done. A lot of the time, we question whether we'll be successful, whether it'll work, whether the world will see us the way we see ourselves. And I also want to thank you for being so courageous, because not only are you standing firm in who you are, natural, standing so glorious, but the world has seen it and has modeled a beautiful international doll after you. I mean, how did that feel? I'm sure that's also right up there with your highlights.
I was gonna mention that, because that is probably the most epic thing that has happened.
I mean, you've got a baby Lira doll. That's crazy.
I literally have my nunus. That's another huge affirmation for the journey. This is what I mean, is that when you are brave and you stick to your guns, you never know what the future may hold. The world is paying attention. Sometimes you might graft for a very long time. I've been in the industry since 2001, so it's been a long journey, but it's been worth it. So it hasn't been easy, but it's worth it. So the doll, I think my favorite thing about the doll is its hair.
Yeah.
The first time I saw it, I was like, oh. Because I expected them maybe, you know, to just have the actual rubber on as their hair.
Oh, yes.
But they developed a specific technology to honor my hair.
No.
Yes, girl.
So, Lira, what we're looking at in that image is not just the rubber waves. It's actually fluff, it's something that you can interact with.
It's the most, I mean, texture. I get goosebumps. It's actual hair. It's little hair fibers that they created for the Lira doll.
That is so incredible.
It's the most, you couldn't have paid a greater honor and homage to me. I love this doll. Mm. And given the image that I gave them, they got it spot on.
Absolutely. I agree.
It's got little Lira earrings and it's got my top and it's just everything that I am is depicted in this body.
You know, I wish that when I was growing up and when I was a young girl, because I loved playing with my dolls, I was a girly girl, that I had a doll to interact with that looked like me, that I could relate to, that had the same complexion,
Agreed.
The same rough hair as I do. So it would teach me to celebrate myself.
And that's really the purpose of it, I believe. Yeah. This is what's important. Because I think what it tells a young girl is that she matters, that like she has a place and a space in the world. Mm. And we need to move into that. Exactly. Because everyone is valid. Everyone is important. Everyone has a place and a space and something to contribute. So dolls like this, you know, I have a very strong message in terms of that. And certainly for this girl, I never had that type of doll growing up.
That's so beautiful.
I never had that.
And now you can say under the list of accolades that you have your own doll. Girl, yeah, you can do your victory dance because we celebrate you. Now, look, I'm not the only one that is looking to hear from you. We've got everyone on social media dying to hear from you. So we've asked you if you've got any questions for Lira. And we've got Ukatlego here who says, I would just like to know that if she's been in studio all this time, people are wondering where you've been and what can we expect in terms of new music? Is there a full album coming out already? I miss her.
Oh,
and this is Ukatlego.
Katleo, thanks for the question. And everybody asked me this. I know you guys are like, where's the album? So the album is 2 years old and it is complete. Mm-hmm. So my desire was to release it in the States. Because it was, you know, I've done all this work sort of coming in from outside into the States and it's proven to be difficult to build a sustainable career that way. So I worked with American producers to try and to learn, actually, first and foremost. I wanted to learn how people on that side create songs and go through the songwriting process. So it was the most educational process that I've gone through. And in releasing that side with the rand dollar exchange, folks, it's been tough.
It just gets real.
I'll be honest, it has been tough. And I have a dream, you know, I have a dream. So I'm carving away at the dream and I appreciate your patience, I know. So I am working on just the plan of you know, putting it out there.
And releasing. But we're just grateful that you have the content, you've got the work
very
in hand.
Very much. And it's beautiful. You know, it's the best way I can describe the album is it's very African-American.
Okay.
It's literally a blending of two worlds.
No, I love that. Afro beats in you and a little bit of everything.
It's, you know, it literally, it's like it really feels like two worlds
coming together.
Yeah.
And I think that just epitomizes you so beautifully. We also have Unuk Piwa here who says, she looks 10 years younger. What are her beauty secrets or her beauty regime or diet? Yeah, girl, that's you.
Thank you so much. So the first thing I'll say is be happy. Mm. Just be happy. It seems to do something out here because nothing has really changed. I just take care of this. And this and everything else seems to work. And then I've always eaten well generally, but I think my beauty secret in staying young is just to be happy.
That internal happiness definitely radiates,
I think so,
outwardly. And all of us are telling you, girl, we can get that energy right away. Our last question here from Myers says, when are you coming to Uganda, Miss Lira?
Myers, I know there's a city called Lira in Uganda.
Wow.
And in all honesty, I'll come when you invite me. Invite me, boo.
Well, it's out there. Shout out to you, Myers. I hope that you got that ticket booked because Miss Lira is more than happy to come.
More than happy.
Okay, so we have to hear from Tebow Touch before we leave. Tebow Touch, but this is a bit of a twist on Utebo. Mm-hmm. And he says here, are there any opportunities that you're opening up for up-and-coming acts and artists?
Okay, so the platform where I find the most eager and the most ready artists is the competition that I work on another channel.
Yes, yes.
And the reason I even got on there was to give me that opportunity. Mm. And what I find about that platform is that they are eager. They are actually ready for what I have to offer. Mm. So it's easier to to get to help them. And I've performed with them. Yeah, I've had them on concerts. I've put them onto gigs. So for me, it's literally a way of pulling someone up who is ready and willing. There are lots of people that I meet, they go, Lira, I want to sing. And they just
mental me, Lira.
They're just saying it, you know, just because you see me in a mall. So I need to know that people are serious. It's not a light thing. You've got to be committed. It's not the easiest career.
Absolutely.
But nothing can stop you if your fire is within you. See, it's your responsibility. So if you show me the fire, I'm there for you.
Absolutely. So you basically need people to be knocking on the door for you to open and happily usher them in.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you so much, Lira. Not only for the work that you do in so many different communities and so many different households, but of course, feeding yourself for you to feed us in
return. Oh, I appreciate that. Thank you so much.